Hi students, now we will see a problem in equilibrium of particles in two dimensions. Let me read out the question. Two identical rollers, each of 850 Newton, are supported by an inclined plane. So, two identical in a sense, both are going to have same diameter, each of 850 Newton, are supported by an inclined plane and a vertical ball as shown in the figure. Find the reaction at the point of the support A, B and C. So, A, B and C. So we have to find what are the reaction which is acting at point A, B and C, and assume all surface to be smooth, by means no friction is going to act. Okay. So let me take this ball as 2 and let me consider this ball as 1. So we will divide this and individually we'll find the various reaction acting here, and then we'll go for this ball, because here if you see 1, 2, 3 as well as 4. 4 forces are acting, but here one reaction, here one tension and sulfate. Only 3 forces are going to act. So by means we can use Ramey's theorem to solve this, and then we can go for this. Okay. So here reaction will, okay, so exactly perpendicularly. So this point is A. So RA will be acting towards the object, that is the reaction. And sulfate of 50 Newton. Okay, so 50 Newton is going to act, and similarly, so the joining the midpoint, as such, tension will be acting towards the object. That is tension BE. When you see for this, it will be tension BE. So, in case we find the intermediate angle, so this is one. Tension, here we have sulfate and here we have another reaction. In case we find the intermediate angle, since we know one force, we can solve the problem by Ramey's theorem. So how to find this angle? So here they have given a clue. So this angle is 30 degree, by means, see, let me consider this as a rectangle triangle, this, because this angle, okay, if this is 90 degree, again this is also going to be 90. So this angle is going to be 60 degree. Okay, so let me take this as a whole, another right angle triangle. Okay, this point is going to be 90 degree. Again, previously we saw this as 60 degree. So this is going to be 30 degree. So this angle is over, by means I draw it here. So E point, okay, sulfate is going to act vertically downwards, that is 50 Newton. And here reaction is going to act, so this is at an angle of 30, that is RA. And here we have another, we are supposed to find this angle as well. So this angle, how to find? Okay, so this part is going to be at 90 degree. So since it is acting vertically towards objects, so this whole angle is going to be at 90, by means this is 30, so this is going to be at 60. So this angle will be at 60. So this is a free body diagram. Now we found all the angle, then this angle. So 2, 360 minus 60 plus 30. So that is 270 degree. So for this force, so this is going to be alternate, this is going to be alternate. So this angle is going to be opposite. Okay, for RA, similarly for 50, this is going to be 250 Newton, this is going to be your opposite angle. For this force, that is tension T2DE. So this angle is going to be 30 degrees, going to be your opposite angle. Let me use, since the is at equilibrium, so we'll be using Ramey's theorem. So that is 50 divided by sine of opposite angle is 270, which is equal to TDE. T, that is tension, D to E, divided by, so sine of 30 degree, which is equal to RA
divided by sine of 60 degree. So if we compare, so we know the whole value of this thing. So if we compare these two and cross multiply, so RA value is 43.3 newton. So even if you get the value in negative, doesn't matter. So here all the values will be in positive. Similarly, if we compare these two, so since we know numerator and denominator, if we compare these two, E, D, E, that is tension D to E, that will be 25 newton. Okay, just cross multiply and find the value. Now we'll go to this ball. Okay, so before we go, so let me say here this tension. Okay, so same tension will be acting in the opposite direction, same magnitude. Okay, same 25 newton will be acting in opposite direction, that is T E on D, but same value will be acting. For this, if we draw the free body diagram, so here we have a reaction. Okay, so this reaction will be exactly 90 degree to this surface. Okay, and here we have another reaction which is acting towards object, and here we have a reaction which is acting. Here this is tension and we have sulfate which is going to act vertically downwards. So let me draw the free body diagram. Since four forces are here, we have to resolve all the forces. So sulfate which is going to act vertically downwards, that is 50 newton. Okay, then we have a reaction exactly 90 degree. So exactly 90 degree it will be, that is RC. Now so let me draw x-axis and y-axis. Okay, x-axis and y-axis. So now again this angle was 60 degree. Now what about this angle? So we need this reaction which is acting towards a point D. So we need this angle, that is the angle made by the force, that is here this angle is 60, so this angle is 90 if I consider this triangle. So this is going to be 90, again this is going to be at 30 degree. So this is horizontal, so this force is going to act at an angle of 30 degree, that is 25 newton. Again we have reaction which is acting here, so we know, okay, how to find this angle. Let us find this angle initially, that is with the vertical, then we can convert this angle. Okay, so here again it is going to be 90. Okay, and we know this angle is 30. So if we take, let me take this triangle, not this one, so let me take this triangle. So this is going to act vertically towards 90 degree, so this is going to be 90, this is also going to be 90, so this is going to be 30, by means this is going to be 60. Okay, if this is 60, then come to this triangle. So initially we saw this triangle. Okay, so this was 90 degree and this is 30 degree, which is already given, and we calculated to find as 60. Now let me consider this triangle. So here it is 60, again it is going to make 90 degree here, and this is going to be 30. But we need this angle, that is the angle made with the horizontal, this is going to be 60 degree. I hope you have understood. So that is, so this point is RB, which is making an angle of 60 degree. So now let us resolve the force and find the value of RB and RC. So now considering the whole system is at equilibrium, by means summation of force along x axis equal to 0. So now we have to resolve all the forces. So here this is making an angle of 30 degree. Okay, so this part, since it is acting at an angle, it is going to be resolved into horizontal component and vertical component. Horizontal component is going to be the component which is closing the angle, that is, so here we have minus sign, minus, again we have plus and plus. So this arrow is pointing towards this side, so that is going to be minus 25 cos 30 degree. Okay, then we have another horizontal force, that is here it is pointing towards positive. So here we have positive plus RC. Okay, then this is vertical, need not to bother. Again here we have another horizontal, that is RB, that is going to be, so this is going to be your horizontal component. So closing angle is going, closing component is going to be your horizontal component. Exactly opposite is going to be your vertical component, that is minus, again this direction, here it will be minus, minus RB cos 60 degree, which is equal to 0. So which is equal to 0. We have two unknowns, RC and RB. Let this be as such. Now summation of force along y axis equal to 0 by means. So here the vertical component is going to be, so again if you made this component as a vertical component, downwards we have minus, so minus 25 sine 30. Then here we are not supposed to bother because this is an horizontal component, and here we have a vertical component again, that is minus 50, and here we have another vertical component, but this vertical component will be pointing upwards, so it is going to be plus RB sine 60 degree, which is equal to 0. If we see here we have only one unknown, that is RB, so by solving this equation we can find the value of RB, that is 57.7 Newton. So similarly, after finding the value of RB, we can substitute the value here, because we have only two unknown here and we have found the value of RB. If you substitute here, we can find the value of RC as well. So RC, we substitute in this equation, so that is going to be 72.17 Newton. So we have found the reaction, which is at A, B and C, that is C, B as well as A, that is A. I hope you would have understood this. Thank you students.